Prove all things and hold fast that which is good. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5:21 teaches us this great principle of testing things and making sure that what we hold to be truth, what we hold to be the best or good, is that which is true. Jesus said, "You shall know the truth. The truth shall make you free." And so we want to hold fast those things, but there's a testing that has to be done. How many times have you found yourself maybe looking to test things, but the way you do it is looking for something that agrees with your already preconceived ideas? I want it to be this way, so I go and I find a source that agrees with me. That reminds me of something that took place in 1 Kings chapter 22. We read about the Syria was coming up against Israel, and Israel is talking with Judah about how they're going to overcome this. The king of Syria, of course, coming against Ahab, the king of Israel, and Jehoshaphat, the king of Judah, are talking about works and how they should inquire of the Lord to ask, is this really what we need to do to go up against them? As a matter of fact, when you get down to verse 7 of chapter 22, Jehoshaphat said, all of these wise men, all of these prophets come before Ahab and they give him a good report. Yes, sure, go up against, God's going to prosper you. But listen to what it says in verse 7. Jehoshaphat said, is there not here a prophet of the Lord besides that we might inquire of him? And the king of Israel, verse 8, says to Jehoshaphat, yes, there is one more man, Micaiah is his name. He says, the son of Imlah, but I hate him, he says, for he doth not prophesy good concerning me, but evil. And Jehoshaphat said, let not the king say so. Jehoshaphat says, I understand what you're saying, but don't say such things. If he's prophesying for the Lord, it's God's message to you, and we should listen to him. But listen again to what Ahab said. I hate him. Why? He doesn't tell me what I want to hear. He doesn't tell me what I want to hear, so I don't want to listen to him. But Jehoshaphat says, let's bring him in. Let's hear what he has to say. This is important. We want to make sure that we're proving all things and holding fast to what is good. Now, if you keep reading, you go down to verse 12, and you'll see that the other prophets prophesied saying, go up to Ramoth-Gilead and prosper, for the Lord shall deliver it into the king's hand. And the messengers was going to Micaiah, and they're going to tell him this is the same thing. You make sure you declare good unto the king. This is verse 13. Let thy word, I pray thee, be like the word of one of them that speak that which is good. Tell him what he wants to hear. We're all doing this. You do it as well. Come along. Fit in with us. This is what you want to do, right? Tell the king good news. But listen to verse 14. And Micaiah said, as the Lord liveth, what the Lord said unto me, that will I speak. So he's going to tell the king what God wants him to say. As you continue reading, you get to verse 24. Zedekiah, the son of Kenaniah, went near and smote Micaiah on the cheek. He slaps him on the cheek because he tells the king what he doesn't want to hear. He doesn't agree with all the other prophets. And he literally slaps him and says, which way went the Spirit of the Lord from me to speak unto thee? Micaiah had told all these other prophets, he told the king that a false prophet, a false message from God has come into these people's minds to tell you what you want to hear. They're just trying to ease your conscience. But I'm going to tell you what God says. And so the king says, put him in prison. You go down to verse 27, give him the bread of affliction and the water of affliction. Put him in prison. He says, until I come in peace. Oh, king's got it figured out. I'm going to win this victory. I'm going to do what these other prophets have said. Verse 28, Micaiah said, if thou return at all in peace, the Lord hath not spoken by me. And as you continue reading, you know the end of the account. The king Ahab, he dresses Jehoshaphat up in his robes, and Syria thinks that this is to be the king, and their mission was to kill the king, and they're going to attack Jehoshaphat. Well, he cries out to them, it's not me, and they realize that he's not Ahab. So what happens? Perchance, the text says, a stray arrow flies and hits the king, King Ahab, and smote him. He died as a result of that arrow, just as God had said. Now, what's the point behind all of this for our Monday meditation? We need to be testing all things. We need to prove all things and hold fast to that which is good. But make sure that we're honest with our testing. Make sure that we're not just looking for someone who agrees with us. We need to make sure we agree with God. Something on which to meditate this Monday. May God bless you until we meet again.